Hello everyone, welcome back. Here is our new episode with latest SpaceX and space news. So, let's get started.
SpaceX's top executives are planning to visit Capitol Hill this Wednesday. They want to talk to government officials about making the process of getting permission from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, easier and faster. This is important because it will help SpaceX launch its Starship tests and Falcon 9 rocket missions without too much delay. SpaceX is looking to simplify the steps for getting permission to launch their rockets. They want to make it quicker and more efficient. Right now, they must go through a lot of paperwork and waiting, and they hope to change that. The company needs to test their Starship and launch their Falcon 9 rockets for various missions. These missions can be sending satellites into space or taking astronauts to the International Space Station. But the long wait for approval can slow them down, and they want to avoid that. So, SpaceX is going to talk to lawmakers in Washington, D.C. about how they can make the approval process smoother and faster. They believe that if they can do this, they will be able to do more space missions and achieve their goals more easily. Before the meeting with the U.S. Senate Subcommittee on Space and Science, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service shared that it might take quite a while to finish the approval process for SpaceX's second Starship test flight, possibly extending until the spring of 2024. In a statement released on Tuesday, a representative from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service explained that they had received a final report regarding the impact on wildlife from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, on October 5. Now, they need up to 30 days to thoroughly examine this report. This step followed a letter from the FAA sent to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service back in August, which requested a reevaluation of how the Starship test flight might affect species that are protected under the Endangered Species Act. So, it appears that the process of securing approval for the Starship test flight is facing delays due to these environmental considerations. Under Section 7 of the Endangered Species Act, reinitiation of formal consultation is required when a project and its impacts change significantly, the amount of take issued previously is exceeded, we have new information on listed species not previously considered, or a new species is listed, the spokesperson said. Reinitiation involving major changes in effects analysis or changes in the FWS, biological opinion are addressed fully in a new consultation. For SpaceX reinitiation with FAA, we are considering the operation of a water deluge system. As part of the investigation carried out by SpaceX following the unsuccessful launch of their first integrated flight test on April 20, 2023, a list of 63 corrective actions was developed. Among these actions was the implementation of a new deluge system. This newly introduced deluge system has already been put into operation a few times. It was utilized during a pair of static fire tests for Booster 9, which is slated to be the next rocket to take off for SpaceX, in conjunction with Ship 25. On a recent Tuesday, SpaceX assembled the rocket, but the following day, they took it apart, indicating the company's commitment to thorough preparation and safety. Following the stacking process completed on Monday, SpaceX posted on the social media platform X, stating, "Starship fully stacked while the team prepares for a launch rehearsal. We continue to work with the FAA on a launch license." However, obtaining that launch license may still take some time. After the FAA's 30-day review of the final biological assessment, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, FWS, has 135 days to provide an amended biological opinion. This suggests that regulatory approval for the launch may not be imminent. The 135-day timeframe mentioned earlier consists of two parts. First, there's the formal consultation period, which might extend for up to 90 days, and then there's the process of creating the biological opinion, which takes an additional 45 days. When reached out to the FAA for information on the steps they will take once they receive the amended biological opinion from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, FWS, a spokesperson for the FAA stated that they would respond to our inquiry. We will provide updates on this story as soon as any further details become available. This revised schedule coincides with Bill Gerstenmaier, who serves as SpaceX's Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability, getting ready to present his testimony before the Senate Subcommittee on Space and Science. The panel's focus will revolve around various aspects of U.S. commercial human space activities, with input from representatives of Blue Origin, Virgin Galactic, National Aerospace Solutions, and CS Consulting. Their discussions will span topics ranging from suborbital flights to lunar surface habitats. The selection of Starship as the Human Landing System, HLS, For NASA's Artemis 3 and Artemis 4 missions is a significant milestone for SpaceX. However, there are several key demonstration flights that must be completed before NASA can authorize its astronauts to fly aboard Starship. These demonstrations include ship-to-ship refueling and an uncrewed lunar landing. In an interview with Ars Technica, a senior SpaceX official revealed that the company has been facing challenges due to a backlog in the FAA's regulatory work. This backlog has forced SpaceX to make difficult decisions about what they want the agency to prioritize in terms of their launch vehicles. The official stated, "Licensing at this point for Starship is a critical path item for the Artemis program and for our execution. Certainly, looking forward into next year, we really need to operate that program at a higher cadence of flights. 6 to 8 months turnaround time for regulatory approval is not ideal for the program. Given the current pace of regulatory approval, it is possible that the turnaround time could stretch to a year or even more. This delay could impact SpaceX's ability to meet the demands of the Artemis program and conduct the necessary demonstration flights to ensure the safety of crewed missions aboard Starship. So that's all about today's episode. See you tomorrow, and until then, goodbye.